All right, tech family, with me is the new Yoga 9i for 2022, which I was super excited to try. Firstly, it has Intel's 12th gen processor inside, and I haven't tested any laptops with it. And secondly, this is Lenovo's flagship consumer convertible, and Lenovo has been on a tear recently, and I wanted to see how good their top consumer offering is. But after using this laptop for over a week, and especially coming off the back of using the excellent MacBook Pro 14, honestly, I wasn't entirely pleased. My unit has the Intel 12th Gen i7 1260p processor, which has 12 cores, 4 performance cores, and 8 efficiency cores. It also comes with 16GB of RAM, a 1TB SSD, and a stunning 14-inch OLED panel with excellent color accuracy. I measured the brightness at just under 400 nits. This is bright enough to be used in almost any environment. However, the screen is quite reflective, which you'll notice in my B-roll. When looking at darker content on the screen, like say watching a movie, at times I did find myself having to adjust the angle of the screen so lights behind me weren't visibly reflecting off it. Given its excellent pixel density of 3840 by 2400 and its 16:10 aspect ratio, I had no problem setting window scaling to 225%, which enabled me to see a ton more content than the recommended 300%. In fact, on par with the most content I've seen on a Windows laptop to date with a 14-inch or smaller screen. But not as much content as on my MacBook Pro 14, which I also set to the most content I could see on screen without needing to squint. Talking about the MacBook Pro 14, on-screen movement on it did look smoother as its display can refresh at up to 120Hz. The Yoga 9i, on the other hand, can't go above 60. Where the Yoga 9i shines though is in its touchscreen and pen functionality. It can be used in several form factors, including as a tablet. In this capacity, the 9i works very well. The pen was great and was accurate, as was the touchscreen. Little note. This seems to be a newer version of Lenovo's Active Pen. Unlike the prior model, which used a single AAA battery to charge, this model is charged via USB-C, which is super handy. When it comes to the chassis, I love it. The laptop feels extremely high quality and sturdy. I love the rounded edges on these new Lenovo laptops. It makes them super comfortable to use. As a result of the sturdy build, screen and keyboard flex is kept to a minimum. Also, for a 14-inch laptop with this stronger chassis, its weight is quite good, less than the MacBook Pro 14's. That being said, when operating it as a tablet, it definitely feels heavy. By the way, I want you to pay close attention to how lightweight the IdeaPad Carbon Edition is. That laptop is also a 14-inch one by Lenovo, and as you're about to see later in this video, it is a very important one when it comes to performance. Back to the Yoga 9i. The laptop does open with one hand, which surprised me, as most of these convertible laptops do not. Normally, convertible laptops have stiff hinges, so that the screen doesn't wobble when you touch it. This laptop both opens with one hand and still has a hinge that is stiff enough for the screen to not wobble when you touch it. By the way, due to how sturdy the laptop's chassis is, I found it very difficult to take the back off to see the internals. So, rather than risk damaging the laptop, I confirmed with Lenovo that the RAM and Wi-Fi is soldered and the SSD is replaceable. The Wi-Fi does support 6E though with a new 6GHz band, which is great, so it's unlikely you'll want to upgrade that anyway. Rounding out the chassis, you've got a great port selection. On the left side, you have two USB-C ports that both support Thunderbolt. You also have one USB-A port of the faster 10 gigabit variety. On the right, you have another USB-C port that doesn't support Thunderbolt, but is also the 10 gigabit one, and a headphone mic combo jack. Because all three USB-C ports do support charging, you won't have to run a cable around the back if your outlet is on the other side of the laptop, which is great. The keyboard I don't love. At first try, it does feel decent, but after a while, you'll notice the keys feel a bit spongy and mushy, especially if you've tried the latest MacBook Pro keyboards. Also, the spacing of the keys seems a little far apart. Plus, the special keys off to the right results in the keyboard shifted a little to the left. At times, this meant I accidentally hit the fingerprint reader rather than the right arrow key. Overall, I mistyped more on this laptop than any other laptop I've recently tested. On the positives, its keyboard backlight works well, and I do appreciate Lenovo's intuitive special keys. For example, switching the function keys to their regular F2, F3 functions, etc., which you'll want to do for things like Excel work, it's as easy as pressing the function and escape key together. The trackpad I also don't like. It is very large, which is good, and tracking is accurate. I found though, when I press down to click, the cursor can jump a little. That's because this trackpad is mechanical, not like Apple's, which don't physically depress when you click them. Apple just makes it feel like it's clicking. In other premium Windows laptops that do have a mechanical click, this isn't such an issue. This one, I don't know, it just feels like it's a bit looser or maybe a bit deeper. Honestly, because of it, I wasn't 100% accurate when clicking on something with this laptop. Look, rounding out the keyboard and trackpad, both are decent and would be very good on a budget laptop, but on a premium one, I just don't think they're good enough. The sound from the laptop speakers are exquisite, especially for vocals. Very clear, immersive soundstage, and they get loud. So when watching a movie, it is a great experience. But, when playing fuller audio like EDM music that requires bass, the sound is nowhere near as good as that of the MacBook Pro 14s. Before we hit performance, a couple of other items for you. This laptop has a fingerprint reader and Windows Hello facial recognition, so plenty of ways to get you logged in fast. Here's how the Yoga 9i's webcam looks and sounds in natural lighting conditions, but as you're about to see, not all of these new 1080 webcams are created equal. And here is the MacBook Pro 14's 1080 webcam in the exact same lighting conditions. To me, it looks a little better and it sounds a lot better. The webcam has a physical privacy filter, and the laptop comes with a soft carrying case that can also hold the pen, which is nice. All right, let's get into performance. Now, I got to admit, after watching several other reviewers' videos of Intel's 12th gen laptop processors, I was worried. What I saw was, yes, they can run fast, but they chew up a ton of power to do it. This generates more heat and may result in more fan noise to cool the laptop. Plus, I've seen all the marketing hype about Intel changing the game, with it now offering two different types of cores, performance and efficiency cores. At the end of the day, I don't care about the hype. Let's see if it actually makes a difference. For my tests, I set the laptop to extreme performance in Lenovo's Vantage software and best performance mode in Windows. All drivers, BIOS, and program versions were updated to the latest. In Geekbench, which tests a variety of common tasks, the 9i single core score was excellent, as was its multi-core, a good amount higher than the Ryzen 5000 laptops in my tests, and substantially better than the Intel 11th gen laptops from last year, particularly in multi-core. But, only on par with Apple's lowest end MacBook Pro 14 M1 CPU, the one with the 8 CPU cores and 14 GPU cores. In Cinebench, which tests the processor's performance when it is maxed out, now you can see the Ryzen CPUs really flex their muscles, eking out very similar performance to this Intel 12th gen. And keep in mind, these are the Ryzen CPUs from last year. Once again, the MacBook Pro 14's lowest end CPU still keeps up with this new offering from Intel. But this is far from the whole story. Things only get worse for Intel from here. When under full load, to equal the performance of Ryzen and the lowest end MacBook Pro 14 CPU, this CPU draws lots of power, much more than those laptops. This results in a slightly hotter feeling chassis, a hotter running processor, and more fan noise, substantially so compared to the MacBook Pro 14. Before we move on, I told you I'd call out the IdeaPad Carbon Edition, which scored very similar Cinebench tests as this laptop. The Ryzen processor in that laptop required far less power to get those results, and it ran a lot cooler. It even had a tad less fan noise, and guys, it's super lightweight. I seriously need to do a full review of that laptop, as I absolutely love it. Let's talk about regular use though, just say browsing the net or using office applications. In this use case, the chassis remains very cool to the touch. However, the fan is pretty much always on. In a quiet room, you'll definitely hear it. And the moment you do anything on the laptop, like installing a program, the fans ramp up and it's very audible. It's not as annoying as my HP Spectre 14 with Intel's older 11th gen CPU where the fans pulsate, meaning it is quiet and then all of a sudden they come on very loud. But unfortunately, this laptop has some of the most distracting fan noise of any consumer laptop we've had in the studio. I was keen to see if there were significant improvements to the integrated graphics. So I ran the FireStrike benchmark and then TimeSpy. Yes, there are some improvements compared to Intel's 11th gen integrated graphics. In fact, it almost scored as high as the dedicated NVIDIA MX450 in my IdeaPad 5 Pro. But this is still nowhere near as good as a low-end dedicated graphics like the NVIDIA 3050 Ti. And you definitely notice this. When I tried to edit one of my 4K YouTube videos, the laptop couldn't handle it as things were super choppy with tons of drop frames. My MacBook Pro 14, on the other hand, which as I keep saying, has their lowest M1 Pro CPU inside, edits videos like a champ. So, similar to the last generation of Intel processors, the integrated graphics is the same in that you'll be able to play casual games like League of Legends on this, but nothing more. Let's look at battery life. Does Intel's 12th gen processors with its efficiency cores help here? Nope. I measured a measly 4 hours and 30 minutes of battery life in my test. That's streaming a movie from Netflix on repeat over Wi-Fi. And no, I'm not joking with that score. Yes, I was on Lenovo's battery saving setting, and I did have Windows set to best power efficiency. I also had the screen turned down 3 notches of brightness. You will probably get longer battery life if you turn down the screen further. Perhaps this is to do with software not being optimized for Intel's 12th gen processors, but honestly, right now, battery life on this, it's pretty bad. Perhaps it only happens on some units, as Digital Trends, for example, reported much longer battery life on theirs. Look, clearly, I've only tested a single laptop with an Intel 12th gen processor, so my thoughts are far from statistically significant. But from this sample, Intel continues their run of the most disappointing laptop CPUs you can buy. Perhaps things are different for larger laptops with better cooling solutions and higher power delivery, but right now, I feel sorry for Windows manufacturers like Lenovo who likely have to put these in their laptops as they can't get enough stock of AMD. Before I conclude, I want to take a stand against the McAfee bloatware pre-installed on this laptop. McAfee bombards you with advertisements to scare you into purchasing a license. It is so scammy. Folks, Windows comes with Windows Defender that has a lot of standard protections built in, like antivirus. Check this pop-up out that interrupted our Cinebench test. Yes, of course, you can uninstall McAfee, but you shouldn't have to. You are paying top dollar for this laptop. You should not be constantly marketed to in this way. If this was a super budget device like Amazon's Fire tablets, I get it. The company needs to make money to offset the device's price through advertisements, but not here. No, no, no. Even Lenovo's own software has annoying pop-ups. Check this Lenovo One out. There is no way to permanently dismiss it. I don't want to be reminded about whatever this is. I want to get rid of it. This has to stop. All right, let's wrap. This is a high quality laptop, but it suffers from two main issues. One, the constant fan noise, which I believe is probably to do with having to cool Intel's 12th gen processor. Other consumer Lenovo laptops that I've had with Ryzen 5000 processors, like the IdeaPad Carbon Edition, honestly, they're much quieter. And two, the price. My configuration of this laptop is a Best Buy exclusive that will be on sale for $1,930. For the kind of people who are likely to be considering this device, i.e. people who don't need high-end graphics and just want a good premium portable laptop, the MacBook Pro 14, even the lowest end configuration, is way better, and it doesn't cost that much more. The config with equivalent specs to this one can be had on Amazon for about $2,250. Its keyboard is more comfortable, its trackpad is way better, its webcam is better, and of course the M1 Pro chip runs circles around this Intel 12th gen processor. It's more powerful in graphical intensive tasks, it runs way cooler to the touch, has substantially less fan noise and longer battery life. I would only consider the Yoga 9i if it were at least $500 less than the MacBook Pro 14, or if you wanted one of the unique features of this laptop that the Mac just doesn't have, i.e. you're an artist and want to draw on the screen with a pen, or you want to run Linux, or something like that. Now, Best Buy and Lenovo are well known to have regular rotating sales on most of their laptops, so if this drops to about, say, $1,500 and they release a BIOS update to reduce the fan noise, then I do think it's worth considering. When editing this video, we did find a cheaper configuration that could be coming, but it only has 256GB of storage, 8GB of RAM, and loses that nice OLED screen. Look, don't get me wrong, guys. The Yoga 9i, it's a good device. And if you aren't overly fussy with a bit of fan noise and you buy it at a good price, you'll probably be pretty happy with it. The problem is, in 2022, The MacBook Pro 14, it's just a much better device. Well, that's all for today, folks. If you like this video, you know what to do. Smash that like button and get subscribed. Not only does it show your appreciation for the insane amount of work that goes into making these, but as I always say, it makes my mother very proud. Make sure to follow me on Instagram, TikTok, and Twitter for plenty of behind-the-scenes coverage. And if you are feeling generous, try becoming a Patreon supporter. Honestly, it helps keep the channel independent so that I can provide tough reviews just like this one. Anyway, till next time, go do something awesome with your day, and I will catch you later.